In this video, I want to start talking about the initial value problem for PDEs. We'll discuss the diffusion equation, because this is a very fundamental and important equation. And we'll go through, I think, three different methods for solving the diffusion equation. I want to teach you a little bit about the von Neumann stability analysis, because some of these methods for solving PDEs can be unstable, where the solution blows up, goes to infinity unexpectedly. And as a numerical methods person, you should be aware of how a method can become unstable. So let me introduce the diffusion equation. We're going to look for the solution for U, which will be a function of one dimension, position x, and also a function of time. The diffusion equation tells us partial of u with respect to time is equal to the diffusion constant times the second derivative of u, partial squared u, with respect to x squared. Okay? So we're talking about a diffusion in one dimension, but it's diffusing in time. Okay, and then we have certain boundary conditions. We specify the value of u at the ends of the spatial domain. So we have a u, say, at minus lx for all time. And I'm going to set it equal to 0, as I'm going to set the value of u at lx for all time also equal to 0. So these are the boundary conditions, BC for boundary conditions. In an initial value problem, we also have initial conditions. So we have u for all x at t equals to 0 is some given function of x. So I'll call that u naught of x. Okay? That specifies our diffusion equation problem, the partial differential equation, the boundary condition, and then this is the initial condition, IC for initial condition. To solve this equation, we have to discretize the equation. We need a grid. Let me just schematically show you what this grid would look like. So we have our x-axis here, and we would have grid points. So let me draw, put a dot here. So let's say these are our grid points. So this is the x direction. And then we have the t direction. And the boundary conditions then are going to be the values at the ends. So we'll have values here and values here. These are supposed to be 0 with our boundary condition. And our task then is, given the initial condition, t equals 0, and the boundary conditions, we want to compute these interior points, right? So they keep going up in time, right? So these interior points will keep going, moving up in time. So the initial value problem is given the boundary conditions, given the initial condition, compute all of these values of u at all of these interior points. Okay. We'll have a delta x here when we define the grid. We'll have a delta t when we define the time-stepping parameter, okay? We have grid points, so we'll have the grid points will be in position, will be x sub j, and then we'll have time, you know, the value of u at certain times, we'll call that t sub l, the certain time steps that we evaluate u, and then we'll call u at x j and t sub l, we'll call that u sub j superscript l. So the standard notation is that the spatial dimension goes on the bottom of U, and then the time, where you are in time, goes on the top of U. So this doesn't mean U to the L power. It means U at the L time step at the J spatial position. Okay? Then we have to go and have a scheme for discretizing the diffusion equation. That scheme is called the forward time centered space scheme. Okay? And that will have the acronym FTCS. Okay? So how do you set this up? We need a grid. So let me draw the grid. We have 3 points here, and then just 2 points in time. So this is the time axis. This would be time step L. This would be time step L plus 1. This would be grid point J. This would be J minus 1 and J plus 1. Okay? We have to discretize du dt, and we have to discretize d squared u dx squared. Okay? So to get to the L plus 1 time step, we're going to write the derivative at the L time step. So we're going to have our center difference approximation for the second derivative. So we're going to need the value here, the value here, and the value here to get to the L plus 1 time step. So the spatial derivative will use these three grid points. And then the time derivative, du dt, we're going to use the Euler method to march forward in time. So we're going to use the L plus 1 time step at the jth grid point and the L time step at the J grid point. So the time derivative will use these X grid points, and the spatial derivative will use these circle grid points. Okay, so what does the equation look like? D squared U dt, partial of U with respect to t, uses this value on the Euler method. So that would be U L plus 1 at the J point, right, minus U L at the J point divided by delta t. That's just the Euler method for partial of U with respect to time. And that's equal to D times the second derivative of U with respect to X, and we'll make use of the circles here. So the second derivative of U with respect to X then will be this U at J minus 1 L, right? Minus 2u at jl plus u at j plus 1l. So the finite difference approximation for the second derivative divided by delta x squared. Okay? So we're using the Euler method for the first derivative in time. Okay, so just a first order difference approximation for the first derivative in time. And we're using the second order difference approximation for the second derivative in space. Okay? That's the discretized diffusion equation. Then if we want to write this as an iteration scheme, we have a U sub J L plus 1 on the left and everything else on the right. If we do that, we get our scheme. So let me put it down here. We get U sub J L plus 1 is equal to u sub j l plus a factor d delta t divided by delta x squared. And then we have a u sub j minus 1 l minus 2 u sub j l plus u sub j plus 1 l. Okay? And that becomes our iteration scheme. Okay, so remember we're getting that from discretizing the diffusion equation using a first order difference approximation for the time derivative and using a second order difference approximation for the spatial derivative, the second order derivative in space. We get this equation and then we just solve for u sub j super L plus 1, put everything on the right-hand side. I said this is an explicit method. What I mean by an explicit method is that the time step value at L plus 1 depends on just the time step value at L. So given the initial condition, we know u, say, at L equal to 0, or L equal to 1, then we can calculate u at L equal to at the value of time step 2. And then given that we know u at the value of time step 2, we can calculate u at the value of time step 3. It's called an explicit method because we know the right-hand side here to calculate the left-hand side. Okay, let me summarize. I want to show you how to solve an initial value problem in a PDE, and we're going to use the diffusion equation then as our model equation. We have boundary conditions and we have initial conditions. We need to grid up the domain. We have a delta x and a delta t. You have to set up the grid. Usually I set up the grid by saying I want so many grid points in x, and that delta t is going to be some specific value. And then we need to discretize the diffusion equation. I did it here using what's essentially an Euler method, a first order method for time, and a centered difference approximation, a second order method for the second derivative in space. And then write it as an explicit scheme. So here is the explicit scheme. In the next video, I want to look at the stability of this method. And I'll show you that for a certain, if the time step is too large, this method can actually turn out to be unstable. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.